Turn my mic up louder, I got to say something. Lightweight, step it aside when we come in. Feel it in your chest, the syllables get pumping. People on the street, they panic and start running. Words on loose leaf sheet, complete coming. I jump in the mind, I'm jumping in the mind, I'm thumping. Healing the brine, I promise to let the sun in. Sick of the dark waves, he marches to the drumming. Jump when they tell us that they want to see jumping. Fuck that, I want to see some fist pumping. Risk something, take back what's yours and say something that you know they might attack you for. Cause I'm sick of being treated like I had before. Like it's stupid standing for what I'm standing for. Like this war's really just a different brand of war. And like it doesn't cater to rich and abandoned poor. Like they understand you in the back of the jet when you can't put gas in your tank. And these fuckers are laughing the way to the bank and cashing a check, asking you to have compassion, have some respect for a leader so nervous in an obvious way, stuttering and mumbling for nightly news to replay, and the rest of the world watching at the end of the day in the living room laughing like, what did he say? But I know what it means. Close your eyes and picture the scene as I painted for you. It was World War II when this man named Kenji woke up. Ken was not a soldier. He was just a man with a family who owned a store in LA. That day, he crawled out of bed like he always did. Bacon and eggs with wife and kids. He lived on a second floor of a little store he ran. And he moved to LA from Japan. They called him immigrant. In Japanese, he'd say he was called Issei. That meant first generation in the United States. When anybody was afraid of the Germans, afraid of the Japs, and most of all afraid of a homeland attack. That morning, Ken went out on his doormat. His world went black, cause right there, front page news, 3 weeks before 1942. Pearl Harbor's been bombed and the Japs are coming. Pictures of soldiers dying and running. Ken knew what it would lead to. Just like he guessed, the president said, the evil Japanese in our home country will get locked away. They gave Ken a couple of days to get his whole life packed in two bags. Just two bags, couldn't even pack his clothes. Some folks didn't even have a suitcase to pack anything in, so two trash bags is all they gave them. And when the kids asked mom, where are we going, nobody even knew what to say to them. Ken didn't want to lie, said the U.S. is looking for spies, so we have to live in a place called Manzanar, where the other Japanese people are. Stop it, don't look at the gunman. You don't want to get the soldiers wondering if they're gonna run or not. Cause if you run, then you might get shot. Other than that, try not to think about it. Try not to worry about being so crowded. Cause someday we'll get out. Someday, someday.
Soon as war broke out, yeah, the FBI came and they just come to the house and you have to come. All the Japanese have to go. They took Mr. Lee, the people can understand why they had to take him, because he's an innocent baby.
So now they're in a town with soldiers surrounding them. Every day, every night, look down at them. From watchtowers up on the wall, Ken couldn't really hate them at all. They were just doing their job and he didn't want to make any problems. He had a little garden, vegetables and fruits that he gave to the troops in a basket his wife made. But in the back of his mind, he wanted his family's life saved. Prisoners of war in their own damn country, what for? And time passed the prison town. He wondered if he'd live it down, if and when they were free. The only way out was joining the army. And supposedly, some men went out for the army, signed on, and ended up flying to Japan with a bomb. That 15 kiloton blast put an end to the war pretty fast. Two cities were blown to bits. The end of the war came quick. And Ken got out, big hopes of a normal life with his kids and his wife. But then they got back to their home, and what they saw made them feel so alone. These people that trashed every room, smashed in the windows and bashed in the doors, written on the walls and the floors, Japs not welcome anymore. Kenji dropped both of his bags at his side as he stood outside, and he looked at his wife without words to say. She looked back at him wiping tears away and said, someday we'll be okay, someday. Now the names have been changed, but the story's true. My family was locked up back in 42. My family was there where it was dark and damp, and they called that an internment camp. Can I please see everybody put a peace sign up in the air?
I remember.
People in the back, can I see a peace sign up in the air?
Then my husband died before they closed the camp.
I love you guys. Thank you so much.
one side.
Huh? You only getting one side?
No, I'm fine. Mine's fine.
You're only getting one side?
And everybody say, thank you, Jim. Thank you, Jim. Thank you, Bradley.
Thank you, Mike.
Yeah, well.